first of all, there is a visible change in the way technology is being deployed in various e-government initiatives. There are essentially two broad aspects of governance. One is G2G operations, and the other is G2C operations. Most of the monies which are spent in so-called e-governance initiatives is being spent in G2C operations. The mindset of these spends is still very dominated with the expenditures, with the procurement of technology products and their deployment. This has one very big gap, and the gap is that the focus is not on the outcomes as much as it is on the procurement, buying of the technology products, and just the deployment. So that area, I think, still I would say that in e-governance initiatives has not been cracked. In terms of scaling up of these operations, I am noticing more and more now state governments taking initiatives into rolling such kind of G2C services using technology. So in last 1 year, there is a definite visible change in deployment of technology, adoption of technology in e-governance initiatives, but I think there is still a lot of distance to cover. Well, one of the biggest challenges in India is the reach. We are talking about inclusive growth. We are talking about including every citizen of India in the journey of prosperity. In other words, it's very important for us to not only look at physically including people into various services that government offers, but also to ensure that people are financially included, that people are digitally included. And if we are deploying technology, then naturally people need to come in touch with technology. And therefore it is very important that they have devices which can be used by them to access government services. So that part becomes a very big challenge. How do we reach out to a billion plus people in 650 odd thousand villages in remotest of the areas, and more importantly, any service needs connectivity. So how do we ensure that broadband connectivity? So it's a huge task. It's enormous. It'll take a long time, I have to say, but we must measure the achievement and accomplishment very, very clearly. There must be quantifiable objectives to any e-governance initiative, and that should be transparent. It should be visible to people, and it should be updated regularly. I think that milestones and the measurement will ensure that it's managed better. Canon is a technology product supplier. We make printers, scanners, faxes, projectors, digital cameras, SLRs, surveillance cameras, etc. So our major role is in ensuring that the technology that we provide and the products that we provide work for the Indian-centric applications. However, there is another important part of this ecosystem, and that part is the system integrators. So Canon works very closely with system integrators. In some cases, we have worked with TCS. In quite a few, we worked with Wipro. We have worked with Acer and many other system integrators, even regional system integrators. And we work closely with them to ensure that they are able to use our products and technology and integrate their services to offer a solution for any government project. So that's more important. And as I mentioned earlier, the focus has to be in the outcomes. And outcomes can only be achieved if the technology and the services are all bundled together, keeping in mind that it is a solution to a problem. So from that angle, Canon does provide all the latest technology. In few cases, we even give a source code where local applications can be built which can sit over our major operating software. So that makes our products a little bit more customized. Canon also has a big role to play in terms of providing after-sale service, because these are hardware products and they go into remotest of the villages. They need constant service support. So these are new challenges. I mean, we had never experienced earlier to be able to go to village level when it comes to services. We had initially, about 3 years ago, we were very proud to have set up 32 service centers or service points in 32 cities. We call them 32 care centers. And then we realized they're far too short. Then we moved and expanded it to about 115 towns. And today, if we are talking about 650,000 villages where these products are going to be used, it's a Herculean task. It's an enormous challenge. In one such recent order that we got from Maharashtra government to supply laser multifunctional products into 28,000 villages, along with the system integrator there. So it's quite a challenge. So we tied up with the local company to set up these so-called franchisee service points. So I think a newer model of service coverage, newer model of service support is also emerging. So we are dabbling with various combinations which will work. And fortunately, it is working when it comes to supplying 28,000 laser multifunctionals in 28,000 villages and providing them the service support. But I think it is still a small tip of the iceberg. There is a lot more work to be done as we scale up, as we scope up, and as we increase our size into taking care of. So UID is a good project. It is a project which will have all the three S's: size, scale, and scope. And it has already started rolling out. Canon supplies the printing products. And for every UID station where images are captured, these receipts are printed. So Canon basically provides laser printers where customer receipts after the biometrics are done is printed and given. So we have so far supplied about 16,000. But looking at the opportunity, UID will need 6 lakh printer devices to man those hundreds of thousands of stations that will be necessary to cover the whole country.
What are the other initiatives with which you are associated?
Some other government projects that we associated. About 2 years ago, it was a Passport Seva Kendra. After that, it was an ESI project of Wipro. Wipro was a system integrator. We are associated with the rural development projects, which is this like Maha Online in Maharashtra. We'll be working with MP Online and the AP Online. And like that, there are every state government is looking at rolling out some programs in villages. So in the rural development area, typically, the rural development ministry also undertakes a lot of rural employment programs. And as the rural employment expands, we will naturally have more of the opportunity and also more consumption in those areas. So in any case, it becomes as a part of a long-term strategy to keep the brand and the products available and accessible to customers in the villages. We have also done some projects or participated in some projects which are related to the police modernization, which Home Ministry is planning to do, and also a Fisherman's ID project, which was done recently. 20% of our revenue comes from government.
And what are your plans for future?
Well, Canon is growing at about 50% per annum as a top line revenue growth. This year, I think we should be growing at about 25% top line growth. So government opportunities for us is also growing at about 25%. So our contribution into government will still remain as 20%. But the variety of programs and variety of newer initiatives that are on your programs of the government which are coming up are creating newer challenges for us and giving us a good experience for our learning curve. Management services is a newer program or newer proposition from Canon, and this is actually a new domain, so to say. Instead of just providing hardware or just the equipment, Canon is talking about integrating hardware along with services, applications, and basically with an objective of solving customers' problems. So few of the important aspects of these propositions are transparency, accountability, confidentiality, cost effectiveness, that means cost saving, audit control, audit trails, monitoring, the entire gamut of basic dashboard provided to enterprises where they can control the expenses that go into printing and copying. They can audit that, and it is basically access controlled, so not everybody can fire a print. It accounts for who is firing a print. You in fact need an ID to be punched in before you are able to take a print. So this managed document services basically migrates the expenses from a CapEx to OpEx, because everything is then attributed to per click cost. India Inc. Totally has close to about 3.8 or 4 million printing devices spread across India Inc., which is the installed base. And together they are printing close to about 8 billion prints a month, 100 billion prints a year. And India Inc. spends close to about a rupee 75 paisa per print. That's the cost, a portion, the machine price, and the consumable. And this translates into the whole thing, translates into a huge cost for India Inc. It's over 10,000 crore. And because of this, there is a tremendous scope for cost saving. There is a tremendous scope for more controlled printing architecture. So right now, only 2% of that is basically in this domain, what we call it managed print services, managed document services. Canon is of course having about 25% share there. This year we should do close to about 50 crores business in managed document services. We just launched about 2 years ago. There are 40 customers that we have signed up with. They're mostly large enterprises from pharma, PFSI, telecom, BPO, IT services, etc. Also real estate. So purely in the areas which are very highly print-centric companies and the activities, and if it's a large enterprise, it is an ideal proposition to go in for managed document services.